When people think of hand winches, the image that often comes to mind is pulling a boat out of the water and onto a trailer. While those types of winches, referred to as pulling winches, are very popular, they are not suitable for most vertical lifting applications. Trying to lower a load with a pulling winch would require the operator to release the locking mechanism while maintaining control of the crank handle that wants to spin freely. Brake winches are fully automatic and self-locking, making them more suitable for vertical lifting. The operator can simply crank the handle clockwise to raise the load, or counterclockwise to lower the load. When cranking stops, the load stops and is held in place automatically. DL brake winches are commonly used in applications ranging from boat lifts, to grain augers, to basketball goals. Our popular DLB series winches range from capacities of 350 to 2,500 pounds. For heavier duty jobs in tougher environments, B-series winches are available in capacities of 1,200 to 3,500 pounds. The brake mechanism in these winches is very simple and reliable, but a little difficult to understand. To more easily explain it to you, and so you can clearly see the parts we're going to be talking about, we have removed the gear cover from this B1500 winch. However, this cover should remain on your winch at all times, unless you are performing maintenance or repairs on it. The components of the brake include the drive shaft assembly, with a large washer affixed to it to create pressure on other parts, and the crank handle, with a large threaded hub, which engages a thread on the end of the shaft. Between the shaft washer and the handle hub are three free-floating parts, a ratchet wheel and two brake pads on B-series winches, or a ratchet wheel, brake pad, and pressure washer on DLB series winches. The ratchet wheel engages a spring-loaded pawl, which allows it to turn only in the clockwise direction. When there is a load on the winch, the thread on the shaft and in the handle hub causes all of these parts to be pinched tightly together. And because the ratchet wheel cannot turn counterclockwise, none of the parts will turn counterclockwise, and the load stays locked in position. Turning the handle clockwise raises the load while keeping all of these parts pinched tightly together. This also produces a clicking noise as the pawl engages the rotating ratchet wheel, which sounds like this. Now comes the part that is hard to understand. To lower the load, the crank handle is turned counterclockwise. But because the ratchet wheel cannot turn counterclockwise, the handle hub ever so slightly starts to unthread itself from the drive shaft and reduces the pressure that pinches all of the parts together. This allows the handle and drive shaft to rotate counterclockwise while the ratchet wheel remains stationary. It is important to understand that at the same time the handle is turned counterclockwise to reduce the pressure on the brake parts, the load on the winch line is causing the drive shaft to turn at the same speed to keep pressure on the brake parts. When cranking stops, the load stops and stays secure without any action by the operator. When the winch is in operation, the amount that the handle hub moves on the drive shaft thread is imperceptible, but movement does in fact occur just enough to keep the brake tight and secure. When the handle is turned counterclockwise, it allows the load on the winch to lower at the same speed that the handle is turned. The handle does not forcibly turn the winch, but instead allows the winch to turn. This means that if there is little or no load on the winch, line may not come out when the handle is turned counterclockwise, and the handle may unthread itself. For this reason, brake winches require a minimum load, which is an amount that assures the load will always move down smoothly. DL brake winches have many important safety features, but they do not meet the standards for lifting people or overhead hoisting. If an application involves a load that could ultimately be above people, a secondary holding device should always be used as a safety precaution. Durable, made in the USA brake winches for simple and safer vertical lifting and lowering. That's the Dutton-Lainson difference. Thanks for watching. We're always interested in hearing what DL products you want us to cover in future videos, so let us know in the comments below.